Morning students, today we'll start new chapter, chapter number 6, triangle. Let me first tell you about this chapter, that few portions have been eliminated, removed from this particular chapter according to a new syllabus. So one by one we'll look for all this. First of all, I want to tell you about the beginning of the chapter. The beginning of the chapter comes with the sentence exercise 6.1, which is actually not very important. Some exam, few fill in the blanks are given in this particular exercise. So we won't see each question, but we will see that what actually is given this exercise. Important thing is congruency, which you know it very well. And the new thing which you will study, similarity. Similar figure, that only I will tell you, similar figure, not triangle, but similar figure we will study. The congruency we have seen in class 9, and from class 8-7 you have been studying that congruency of two triangle. We had some properties, side or side angle, something like that. So in this particular case, actually shape must be equal. If I make a triangle like that, and if I make a triangle like that, if properties will follow, one of the property SSS, SAS or ASA, definitely these two triangles will be congruent. And the logic thing is what? Now, if you pick one triangle, if you will keep the triangle on the second, both should overlap each other. That means it is congruent. Okay. So, we don't have to see the congruence in this lecture. We will see the similar figure. So, let me say something about this. We have two things, shape and size. So, we talk about two figures. Suppose I am making two circles here. Definitely, they are not equal in the size, but they are equal in shape. So, if they are same in shape, They are similar. So try to understand it. They are similar. Even it is a smaller one, it is a bigger one, but they are equal in shape. They are similar figure. So even size are not equal, no matter at all. But we are not talking about the congruency. We are talking about the similar figure. So let me speak one thing. That if you are making more triangle, more circles, if you will make, all circles are similar. Triangle, if you make a triangle, inequilateral triangle, big one, even all the equilateral triangle will be a similar figure. But if we make an equilateral triangle, one is an isosceles triangle, one is a scalene triangle, these are not the, even they are the triangular shape, but still they are not a similar. So hope you are getting me, that one thing I want to pull your attention toward, that This is have a 60 degree, 60, 60. This is a 60, this is a 60, and this is a 60. So very important thing, that this have a 60, suppose. So you know, you have to focus on the angle of the triangle. So if they are all equal, definitely they are similar. You know, one by one will come on that point particular. Sometime, I just want to pull your attention towards that. Look at, suppose it is a 1, 2, 3, it is a 2, 3, 4, 2, we just take a 2 triangle. Suppose I am taking this 2 triangle. Suppose it is 1 centimeter, it is 2 centimeters, 2 centimeters are 4 centimeter. Suppose it is 3 and it is 6. What do you think? Their sides are proportion. 1 by 2, 2 by 4, 3 by 6, all are equal. Sides are in proportion. So this is also one strong point where triangle may be similar. So slowly we'll come on the triangle, but I want to tell you one thing, that if shape are same, definitely they'll be a similar figure, similar shape. Okay. So this was only in the first exercise. Hope you have understood about that. But this is not the discussion point. First exercise even we won't study. We are leaving it because of few fill in the blanks is containing in this exercise, and verbally we have seen very important topic we are studying here, that basic proportional theorem. बेसिक प्रोपोर्शन थ्योरम. इट इज शॉर्टली कॉल्ड BPT और शॉर्टली कॉल्ड थेल्स थ्योरम. सो द मेन थिंग ऑफ द सिमिलैरिटी एक्चुअली इज गोना स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द थर्ड एक्सरसाइज. द सेकंड एक्सरसाइज इज डिपेंडिंग ऑन बेसिक प्रोपोर्शन थ्योरम एंड यू हैव टू सी दैट व्हाट इज दिस. लुक एट, आई टेल यू वन थिंग. द स्टेटमेंट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड आई विल रीड इट एंड आई विल टेल यू दैट व्हाट इज in it. Look at, I'm just reading the statement. If a line drawn parallel to one of the sides of the triangle intersect the other two sides at two different points, the other two sides are divided in the same ratio. This is the statement. So let me make the picture. If a line drawn parallel to one side of triangle, okay, suppose this is a triangle ABC. We have a three side. A line is drawn parallel to one of the side of the triangle. Suppose I am choosing one side BC and I am making the parallel side of BC from here. Suppose I draw a parallel line of BC which intersect these two sides at B and E, suppose. So question says that this particular line which is drawn parallel to the one of the side BC divides to two sides in same ratio, meaning definitely that DE is dividing AB and AC at D and E. And question says this line divides these two lines at same ratio, meaning AD, DB, AE, EC, these are the parts and these are in equal ratio, meaning AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC. So this is the thing which we have to show it. So look at, I tell you one thing, that in triangle ABC, DE parallel to BC, DE parallel to BC, to prove, we have to prove that AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC. So one thing is given, that these two parallel line, and we have to show that this upon this equal to this upon this. So this is basic proportion theorem, Thales theorem. So we'll start, we construct something. Look at, I tell you, we construct something. So in construction, we will join DC, we will join BE. Let me write, join DC and BE. Also, we draw a perpendicular from E to AD or AB. So suppose it is M and this is drawn perpendicular. Same as we draw perpendicular from this to AE or AC, you can say anything, this suppose L. So two things we will do, EM perpendicular, AD or AB, you can say anything, and DN perpendicular to AE or AC, you can say anything, no matter at all. You don't worry that what you're writing, AE or AC both acceptable, AD or AB both acceptable. So this is the thing which was important. Till here, after doing so, what will start? So beginning, it is very important. You should remember the beginning. So let me speak that how you can begin the question. You have to begin the question from area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle BDE. Try to understand. ADE, and this is the triangle which we'll take. This one. ADE and BDE. So you just have to remember this. And taking these two, we'll start with the formula. You know, formula is 1 upon 2 base into height. So we'll write here 1 upon 2 base into height. What about ADE? So I want to tell you with a separate figure, that this is a ADE and here the area of the triangle ADE is 1 upon 2 base into height. So how you select base? So you know, first you have to select the height. So height is just like a drawn perpendicular you did so. So this is a height and this will decide the base also. So base is AD and height is EM. Now, very interesting thing is coming downside. that you have a triangle BDE. Let me make it here BDE. So this triangle, this is a triangle where one of the important thing telling you that it is again a formula 1 upon 2 base into height. But the question is again that what is base and what is height. So first choose what is height. So height is nothing here. Sometimes students can get confused about what is height, this or this or this. But let me explain that height is here, but it is not in the triangle. Can you catch? Let me tell you one thing, that you did draw EM perpendicular to AB or AD or BD also. It is BD. If you will extend this line and you remember that you did draw perpendicular EM. So this particular EM is actually height of this triangle, even it is outside. Very simple thing I am telling you. I ask you that what is the height of this triangle? So this is not height, this is not height, this is not height. So if you want to find the height, what you will do? You will extend the line and draw the perpendicular. Even it is outside, but it is height. Same as here, student. BD, which is not a base, actually after extending BD, you will see that EM is looking perpendicular on this side. So this will be called base, because after extending that, the drawn perpendicular is visible. So this is going to be height and this is small lines of base. Sometimes student get confused that BM is a base. No, BM is not the part of the triangle. So base always must be the part of the triangle. Height may be changed. Height may be outside of the triangle. So one thing, that base into height, so base will be BD. This BD and height is EM. Now this is the thing which I wanted to tell you. Now what we'll do? 1 by 2 and 1 by 2 cancel. EM is in cancel. And we have the rest thing, area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle BDE is equal to AD upon BD. First equation. Now, same we will do the work on the triangle and this triangle. Can you see? Again, I will go with the same thing. Area of ADE is remain same upside, but downside will change. Area of CED will be taken. Try to understand. First ADE along with BD. Now in the next case ADE will remain same, but the triangle CED will be taken. And this time 1 upon 2 base into height will be taken, but this time I will take height and base will change. Look at, in the rough structure I would tell you, last time I took this as height and this was a base, but this time I am taking this as a height, which is N, and base is this one. So ADE, it is looking like that, and this time DN I will take height, so AE will be its a base. So you have to change it, and now I'm writing here base into height, so base is AE, can you see, AE, and height is DN. Upon 1 upon 2 base into height. So in this case, same figure I'll make here. Can you see? This is a picture is made here. DEC. And same as I tell you that what about the height and base? Can you see that after extending that, DN is looking 90. DN is looking 90 after extending that. So this is the height and this will be the base, because you extend CE till N. And this DN is the height. Definitely this DN will be called the perpendicular on CE. So CE gonna base and height is DN. So I write here 1 upon 2 base into height, CE into DN. It is really simple. Now what will you do? This DN DN cancel, half and half cancel. So remaining thing we have area of triangle ADE upon area of triangle CED is equal to AE upon CE. Now this is the second equation. Now the thing which is I'm telling you, very important. Can you see which is shaded one? This is the theorem you already have studied in class 9th, that these two triangle lying on the same base DE between two parallel line, and you know that when two triangles on the same base between two parallel lines are equal in area. That is the theorem you read in class 9th. So BDE, CED, these two triangle lying between two parallel lines on the same base DE, these will be equal in area. I will write here, since we know that the triangles on the same base and between two parallel lines are equal in area. So what will be equal? BDE, area of BDE, area of a BDE and area of a triangle CED will be same. So this is a simple thing which I explained right here. Both are equal. Now can I say that we have CED? Please focus on that. You can take first equation, you can take second equation. Suppose I am taking second equation. Can you see CED? So CED can I change with BD? So by 2, can I write that triangle, that equation, area of ADE upon area of that CED, I will change by BDE. BDE triangle make equal to AE upon CE will be same. Can you say it is third one? Try to understand that CED, I change it by BDE because both area are equal. And now after doing so, can you compare to equation number 1 and equation number 3? So if you compare to equation these two, compare, after comparing, it is ADE, BDE, it is ADE, BDE. Now both equation left hand side are equal, so right hand will be definitely equal, AD upon BD. Look at by 1 and 3rd, I conclude that AD upon BD, that is a right part, and this is right part, AE upon CE. Hence proved. I think we have completed our requirement. Can you read AD upon BD is equal to AE upon CE? That was the requirement which should be had to show. It was written here. So you know, student, this is very simple but elegant proof, and it will definitely it may come in exam. I didn't see that whether this is in a new syllabus or not, but okay, it was important. Even if it is not a new syllabus, still I have taught you. So keep remember this final concept, final conclusion. Now keep remember, student, even triangle is like that. Try to understand, telling you something. Suppose MN is a parallel to BC. How you will use basic proportional theorem? Keep remember, in a triangle, if a line drawn parallel to one of the side, Thales theorem will be applied. And what is Thales theorem? Look at, you have to start with the vertex. This parallel to this one. So you will start with vertex AM upon MB and AN upon NC will be coming. This is a simple thing. If triangle is like that and the line is from here, suppose ABCDE like that is, you know that if these two are parallel, one can start with C. CB upon BA equal to CD upon DA. So I don't think that I need to tell you much about that because it was simple in first sight. It can be understood. Okay. Now, the next is, I'll start the theorem number 6.2, which is actually converse of BPT. Converse of Thales. Converse of basic proportional theorem. You can understand the converse meaning just opposite statement. And in the last, in this particular Thales theorem, what you studied? You studied that this is ABC it was, and this is a DE which was parallel to, DE parallel to BC was given. And what you have shown? AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC. You shown this one. But in converse of basic proportional theorem, this will be given and this we have to prove. Hope you can understand this. That's why it is called a converse of BPT. In basic proportional theorem, or Thales theorem, it was given, we had to show this one. But in this particular converse of the PT, it will be given and we have to show this one. So I don't think that I need to tell you much again. So let me speak one thing. That statement says, if a line divide any two side of the triangle in same ratio, the lines are parallel, this line is parallel to third side. That simple. What given? This is a triangle and question says, a line divide any two side of triangle in same ratio. A line divide any two side of the triangle in same ratio. Suppose DE is a line which divides AB and AC in same ratio, given that in triangle ABC, DE, line DE divides BC and AC, sorry, AB and AC, excuse me, AB and AC, line DE divides line AB and AC in same ratio, or what is the meaning of same ratio? AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC. This is given. You know, this is given. And now we need to show to prove. What to prove? That lines are parallel. DE parallel to BC. We will prove this one. So this is called converse. Now what we will do specially? Look at construction we will make. Construction, that's very important thing it is. First of all, we assume that we use here contradiction method, and hope you heard this particular word from my mouth. Contradiction method, we studied in class 9th also. This is an opposite method. Actually, what happened, whatever we need to show, we will take its opposite. Like DE parallel BC we need to show, we take that DE is not parallel to BC. Definitely, if DE is not parallel to BC, some, you know, and that the way, when I assumed reverse, that DE is not parallel to BC, when we will do the work, we will get a wrong answer. And why? Because we took a wrong thing. When DE is not parallel to BC, so definitely we will get a wrong answer. And that only our requirement. We need a wrong answer. And that's why finally we'll say that we are getting wrong answer because we assumed wrong. So we make it our assumption correct, and then we can write final sentence D parallel to BC. That is a way. So in construction we write, let DE is not parallel to BC. So one line we assume that, suppose it is E dash. So suppose it is E dash. So let DE is not parallel to BC. Let DE dash parallel to, I think we can start the solution of proof, not any particular construction. Now can you read proof? Let DE is not parallel to BC, let DE dash parallel to BC. Okay, we have drawn it. We have drawn DE dash parallel to BC. Now see the picture. Again I want to make a picture. A, B, C. That is a D, but it is a E dash. Now you assume that DE dash is parallel to BC. So when these two line parallel, use the Thales theorem. You know it now? Thales theorem, what is Thales theorem? If these two sides are parallel, but one can know that these are in equal ratio. So AD upon DB is equal to AE dash upon E dash C will come because these two are parallel. So we can use here the basic proportion theorem. I will use here by basic proportion theorem, BPT, what we can write, AD upon DB is equal to AE dash upon E dash C. That is equation number 2. So this is given and this we have obtained by assumption that DE is not parallel to BC. So DE dash will be parallel to BC. We took and we got this one by basic proportion theorem. So by 1 and 2, can you compare ADDB and ADDB equal? So can you compare AE upon EC is equal to AE dash upon E dash C? We got this one. Now what a good thing I'm doing. How we can prove it is wrong? How we can prove the contradiction? So definitely I recently taught you, told you that I took wrong, I will get a wrong answer. Look at, I tell you how it is. So keep remember one more step here, adding one both side. This is the step you have to remember that. Remember that. Adding one both side. Just keep remembering in the mind that this we have to do. AE upon EC plus 1. AE dash upon E dash C plus 1. Now add it. AE plus EC upon EC LCM. AE dash plus E dash C upon E dash C LCM. AE plus EC, look at picture. AE plus EC equal to AC. So this is AC upon EC. And AE dash plus E dash C is again AC. So AC upon E dash C. So definitely these two will cancel. And here it is 1. It is 1. So when we transfer here, E dash C will be here, EC there. So E dash C will be EC. Now, can you see the picture? E dash C is the distance from E dash to C. And EC is the distance from E to C. Both are coming equal, which is not possible. Can you see? Can you see? It is not possible. It is wrong. It is contradiction. You know, that is the aim. That is the aim. So when we assumed wrong, we definitely have we will get a wrong answer. And we got it. So it is a contradiction. And when it is contradiction, what we will write? We will write that if you want a right answer, we have to change our assumption. So it is a contradiction. So remove the contradiction. Remove the contradiction. What we will write last sentence? Remove the contradiction. We have that what we assumed wrong, this we assumed wrong. So make it the correct DE parallel to BC. That I have corrected. DE parallel to BC. And that is the proof of the theorem. So hope you are getting it. What we assumed wrong, we got a wrong answer. So we made finally the sentence correct, that DE is parallel to BC, and we have done it. So this was a simple concept, but it was very important according to the exam. Regarding that exam, it is I think one of the important questions. It is, so prepare it. So okay, we'll see some more example in the next lecture. Thank you.